70 meter ice bath line, and the ice is breaking up. It's getting warmer. Well, it's not really physically so much warmer, but the ice is definitely broken up. It's slushy in between. Everything's moving again, which is interesting. And I'm just doing a little talking.
I'm not watching.
Yes, you are. We're in the last final stages of the cruise. We're going down the 70 meter isobath line up here. We just passed St. Matthew's Island, which we could see off in the distance, although it was very foggy, so we could just barely make it out. It's snowing, it's still very cold, but we've got slushy parts in between the flows of ice. We're gonna do an ice station this morning, but it was too, we couldn't find any solid ice. So basically we're heading back south and we should be in open water in probably a day or so. We are on a 70 meter isobath. It is May 3rd and it is a cloudy, kind of chilly day, but not too cold. We are doing a full sampling station here because this is a station that we've been to 2 weeks ago. And when we were here 2 weeks ago, we saw a tremendous bloom and there was high productivity because the ice edge was still here. What the scientists are looking for is what are the changes along the ice edge and when the ice recedes. So by sampling this site again, it should be very interesting. We've got Benthos on the surface to see if there's still a high degree of productivity. Of course, water quality sampling, or rather water physical oceanography sampling. We've got various Benthos for plankton and phytoplankton. And then in addition, we're doing benthic grabs so that we can see whether or not the animals that were in within the bloom before, maybe their molting or their waste products have now settled to the bottom, adding a tremendous amount of organic carbon to the system. And that's what the hypothesis is. By sampling here 2 weeks later, we will be able to see the change of the recession of the ice. So it should be really interesting, and it's a great opportunity. And normally that doesn't happen on a research cruise where you're able to necessarily go back and resample.
The Van Veen grab samples the benthos. We're interested in the sediment at the bottom. We want to see both what's down there, and then we want to see how much carbon's getting to the bottom.
Okay.
All the production happens at the surface in the photozone. We have algae production, which then dies and sinks to the bottom and acts as a food source to stimulate the growth on the bottom, where we get clams to feed the walrus, crabs and whatnot for the commercial industries. So it's a very important system that we're interested in. So these first two samples that we take, we're testing for the amount of chlorophyll that's actually in the surface sediment. We'll run it through a fluorometer. We can measure micrograms per liter. And then the second sample we take is a total carbon count. We're measuring how much carbon is actually in the soil. Then we can actually run a test to see physical property of the soil itself, the sediment that sinks. So we can test for the grain size of the sediment, the amount of carbon in the sediment, carbon-nitrogen ratio, and we can determine how productive and where the carbon's been deposited in the sediment from bioturbation.
By well. This is the prey of the monthail.
Thank you.
keep the ice away from the cable. Let's see, we've got ice coming. So Ed fends it off. Basically, they put the camera down and it drifts along the bottom. And as it's drifting with the ship, they get these amazing images of the starfish and anemones and snails and whatever else is down there. We're going to look at the footage later, but they look and make sure that it's the right distance above the bottom. And we saw really interesting things in all of the grabs that they did earlier. So it should be a really interesting, interesting camera deployment. Bringing the camera back in.
Broken shell, Maurice?
Yes.
For hermit crab.
Hermit crab, and then
there we go. Alright. Well, we want to deploy the camera because the grab's only sampling a very small area, so often we'll see things that are down there that we can't pull up in our quantitative samples.
Cool. And so we're seeing brittle stars and...
We're seeing a lot of brittle stars, which we will end up pulling up in grabs. But, for instance, we passed over an anemone in the first minute or two of footage, which we never pulled up. And so it's always worthwhile to note that there are things down there that we're not seeing in our sampling.
And the snail, Tachyrhynchus erosus. A lot of gamarites, amphipods. And the small worms.
Clam's cool. Mm. Is that what you would have expected to find here?
Yes, because we have 7 samples from this place, from this station.
Yeah.
2 weeks ago, maybe more.
Yeah.
3 weeks ago.
3 weeks ago.
Yeah.
And it was and the same?
The same. The same fauna. Sandy bottom. And a little bit mud, all the same.
Cool. The clam is cool. It's also little.
Yeah. Most of animals in this area are very small.